Good morning, students. We will be talking about zener voltage regulator today. So as we have studied in our earlier class about the ordinary power supply, we know that the ordinary power supply consists of input as 230 volt AC. Then we are having a step down transformer, a rectifier and a filter circuit. Now, in an ordinary power supply, we can see that the output voltage changes directly with the input AC voltage. So whenever there is a change in the input voltage, that is 230 volt, there will be a corresponding change in the output voltage that will be taken across the RL load. And also the DC output voltage decreases as the load current increases. That is the load current, that is the current flowing through the load increases. The output voltage will decreases because it is due to the internal resistance, that is the large internal resistance of the ordinary power supply. So in order to overcome that, we are going for the voltage regulator, that we are using a DC power supply with a voltage regulator. Say a voltage regulator is a device which is used to maintain constant DC voltage in spite of the AC input fluctuations or changes in the load resistance value. So this is a regulator power supply block diagram where you can see this is the ordinary power supply block and this is the voltage regulator. So the output of the power supply is given to a voltage regulator which will give a constant output in spite there is change in the AC input fluctuations or the changes in the load resistance value. So the simple voltage regulator used is a zener voltage regulator. For that we are going for a zener diode, which is a silicon PN junction device which differs from a rectifier diodes because it is used for operation in the reverse breakdown region. So this is the circuit symbol for a zener diode. You can see this is the anode and the line, the slanting line indicates the cathode, that is the negative terminal. And this is the manufactured silicon diode which consists of a black ring, and this black ring indicates the cathode and the other terminal is the anode. Now this is the simple circuit for a zener diode. You can see this is the zener diode where this part is the cathode and this is the anode. The cathode is connected to the positive of the battery through a resistor R and the anode is connected to the negative of the battery. So you can see that the zener diode is reverse biased. Then the zener diode is always reverse connected inside a voltage regulator because it works in the reverse biased condition. When forward biased, its characteristics are just like an ordinary diode. And in the reverse bias condition, there is a zener breakdown which occurs, which gives a sharp breakdown voltage called the zener voltage. Then we are having zener diode VI characteristics. You can see this is the VI characteristics. The x-axis shows the voltage and the y-axis show the current. This is the forward bias voltage. This is the reverse bias voltage. This is the forward current and this is the reverse current. So you can see that when it is forward bias, it acts as a normal ordinary diode which is having a cut-in voltage of 0.3 or 0.7 depending upon whether it is a germanium or silicon diode. And in the reverse bias condition, you can see that there is a reverse saturation current and which in turn results in a reverse breakdown. As a result, we are increasing the reverse voltage. So when the reverse voltage reaches a value VZ, which is the zener voltage, there will be a reverse breakdown current IZ minimum. From there, you can see the voltage remains constant. there will be a high increase in the, even though there is a increase in the current, you can see that the voltage remains constant. You can see it is a straight line. And IZ max indicates the maximum current rating of the Zener diode. So from the breakdown current IZ min to the maximum current rating, you can see there is a large increase in the current, but you can see the voltage remains constant. So in the Zener breakdown, you can see it is having a sharp curve which indicates constant voltage. So this ability of the Zener to give a constant voltage help it to stabilize or regulate the voltage source against the supply or the load variation. So you can see there are different types of Zener diodes which is having a voltage value or a constant voltage, and this voltage will be our constant output voltage at the output of the voltage regulator. So when we are having a Zener diode of power rating 500 milliwatt, you can see the voltage ranges from 2.4 volts to 47 volts. And when the Zener diode rating is 1.3 watt, the voltage ranges from 3.3 volts to 62 volts. So these are the different constant voltage outputs which we get at the voltage regulator. Now, we will go in detail about the Zener voltage regulator, the block diagram and the circuit diagram. You can see that the Zener voltage regulator is also called as a shunt regulator. As you can see, the Zener diode is connected parallel with the load. So it is known as shunt regulator. So you can see that this is the input voltage Vi and we are having a resistance Rs. It is connected to the Zener diode, which is the control element, and we are having a load across which the output voltage is measured. And you can see that accordingly, the Zener voltage will be your output voltage Vo. For a parallel circuit, we are having same voltage, right? Now, the Rs is connected in series with the Zener diode to limit the current flow through the diode. Now, in the circuit diagram, you can see that Vi is the input voltage and Is is the current flowing through the resistance Rs. This Is at node A divides into Iz and IL. Iz is the current, Zener current flowing through the Zener diode, and IL is the load current flowing through the load resistance RL. So the voltage across the Zener diode is Vz and the voltage across the load resistance is Vo. So Vo will be equal to Vz. As a result, we will get the regulated voltage. Whatever be the Zener voltage, that will be our output voltage Vo. Now we need to select Rs so to limit the maximum current flowing through the circuit. So we have to select the value of Rs so that we have to limit the current flowing through the circuit. And the load is connected in parallel with the Zener diode so that the voltage across RL is always same as the Zener voltage. Next, how to design Rs and RL. So the Rs value should be between Rs max and Rs min. We will get Rs max value by the equation Vi max minus Vz by Is, where Vi max is the input voltage, maximum input voltage. So Vi can be varied from a minimum value to a maximum value. As a result, we will also have a minimum Zener voltage Iz min and Iz max. Okay, so taking this mesh, you can see that the mesh equation is Vi minus Isrs minus Vz will be equal to 0. So that indicates Vi minus Vz is equal to Is Rs. So Rs is equal to Vi minus Vz by Is. So depending upon the value of Vi, we can get the minimum and maximum value of Rs. When Vi is maximum, we will get the maximum value of Rs. Rs max is equal to Vi max minus Vz by Is. And when Vi is minimum, we will get Rs minimum is equal to Vi minimum minus Vz by Is. Now we can also have an equation which is equal to Rs minimum is equal to V in minus Vz by Iz max, where Iz max is the maximum current rating of the Zener diode, keeping the V in to be a constant value. So this is also an equation which gives us the Rs minimum value. Now we know that from this, VO is equal to IL into RL. So RL is equal to VO by IL. What is VO? VO will be equal to VZ. So from this two equations, we can design the value of Rs and RL. Now next is the working of Zener diode shunt regulator. Mainly there are two cases. We have to get a constant output even though there is a change in input voltage. That is known as regulation when the input voltage is varied. Second case, we have to get a constant output even though there is a change in the load resistance. That is regulation when the load resistance is varied. So first one, regulation when the input voltage is varied. In this case, we are keeping the RL to be fixed. That is the load resistance to be fixed. And the input voltage Vi is varied. So what happens when the Vi is varied? So when Vi is increased, what happens? The Is, the current Is will increase. The current Is increases. And we know that from the nodal equation A, Is is equal to Iz into IL. You know that RL is fixed, so we cannot change the value of IL. IL into RL should remain constant. So as a result, whenever there is a change in Is, that will be reflected in Iz. So as Vi increases, Is increases, as a result, Iz increases, keeping IL constant. Then as Is increases, you can see that the voltage across Rs is Is into Rs. As a result, the voltage drop across Rs also increases, keeping VL to be constant. So whatever change occurs in the Vi is compensated as a voltage drop across Is Rs, or voltage drop across Rs. Now the second case, when the input voltage decreases, the input current will also decrease. Is will also decrease, which in